And we all owe it to one person, Alice Walton. 4029's Ben Wagner shows us why she's the next person on our list.
In a couple words, she's both a visionary and an activist.
Alice Walton's legacy sits atop 120 acres of prime Northwest Arkansas real estate. Crystal Bridges, which opened its doors in 2011, was the Walmart heir's brainchild years before these walls went up.
From the very beginning, she wanted to make certain that the museum embraced the idea of not only displaying beautiful art, but also give every guest the opportunity to enjoy nature.
But it was a project that didn't come easily. Walton said it took some convincing before the Walton Family Foundation agreed on where to build.
When people ask me, why would you build a museum like this in Bentonville, Arkansas, I tell them, why not?
Alice Walton is the youngest of Walmart founder Sam Walton's four children. In this documentary titled The Art of Crystal Bridges, she explains her love for art started at a young age.
I never got much exposure to museums growing up. I just always loved to draw and paint, and that's what started it all.
So on 11/11/11, Crystal Bridges opened its doors to an eager community, and it's paid off.
She just jumps in with both feet when she has a good idea.
Since then, more than 1 million people have visited the American Art Museum.
I think she is a model Arkansan, there's no question.
Sandy Edwards has been the deputy director at Crystal Bridges since it opened. While Walton is the chairwoman of the board, Edwards says you wouldn't know it if you caught up with her inside the gallery.
When she is here at the museum, you will often find her in the galleries asking our guests, what do you like about this art? Let's talk about art.
While philanthropy has guided her professional life, her personal life has been a bit more tumultuous. In 1998, a judge found her guilty of driving drunk when she wrecked her SUV in Springdale. And in 2011, a Texas state trooper arrested her on suspicion of DWI. Those charges were dropped and recently expunged from her record. Recognized as one of the richest women in the nation, those who know her say Walton uses a simpler description of herself.
Alice calls herself a student, which I think is an apt phrase. She is a voracious reader. She loves to learn not only about horses, which are a passion for her, but art. Anything that is stimulating and of the moment, she is very much a student.
In May 2012, the University of Arkansas awarded Walton an honorary Doctor of Arts and Humane Letters. At the ceremony, she revealed a secret to the graduates.
I missed my graduation. I was on the Snake River having a grand old time.
Her contributions to the area go well beyond art. Walton chaired the council that helped create the Northwest Arkansas Regional Airport. The Alice L. Walton Terminal Building is named after her, and hers is a legacy that will continue to grow.
Together we have created a place where all are welcome.
I'm Ben Wagner reporting, 4029 News.
Forbes magazine recently published an article on Crystal Bridges and Alice Walton. They also named her the 8th richest person in America.